I don't know how many of you have been students of history or have had interest in history. Has any of you heard of a king called Lalitaditya? Please raise hands. Lalitaditya? Two hands. Two hands in an auditorium of at least 200 people right now. But I'm impressed, sir. Lalitaditya has been a well-kept secret. I've heard of Ashoka the Great, I've heard of Akbar the Great, and Lalitaditya's empire was both these empires put together. And he ruled from Kashmir, that was his capital. In northwest, it went up to the Caspian Sea. In south, it came right up to the Kaveri Basin. In east, it went to Pragjyotish, which is Kamrup, which is Assam. And it coexisted when the Rashtrakutas were ruling Gujarat and Maharashtra. Kannauj emperor used to send obeisance to him. More important, he ruled when Islam was spreading like a frenzy across Central Asia. And you don't talk about him. Your history books have completely erased him. Not just him, his entire dynasty, which is Karakota dynasty. In 7th century, 8th, in between, cusp, it was 699 to 750. So I wonder, what are we doing to ourselves? And how little we know about ourselves, and we are seeking to decide a few questions which are of far-reaching implication. In what ignorance? Kalhana, the first ever recorded history anywhere in the world of any place, is from Kalhana about Kashmir. Raj Tarangini. In Sanskrit, the word means literally, Raja is kings and Tarangini is the river. So the river of kings, the way time flowed. And this Raj Tarangini, once he finished his own first ever between 949 and 951. He started from the first king Neel, who was the son of Rishi Kashyapa, who retrieved Kashmir from a huge reservoir of water called Satisara. And there is again an elaborate story about that in Neelmath Purana. But I'm not going to keep you engaged in prehistoric texts and prehistoric issues. It is only to contextualize as to where do you decide the time should start for you to know what Kashmir is or has been about. You can go as far as that. But Rajataranginis were written after Kalhan also. Zonaraj was another who, it was almost like a relay race. Where Kalhan left is where Zonaraj picked up. Where Zonaraj left is where Shrivar picked up. Where Shrivar left, another one picked up, and it went on till 17th century. And it tells you what Kashmir has been through in the medieval period also. Islam came to Kashmir in 1339. As in, the first king ascended the throne in 1339, the first Muslim king. He did not come riding a horse winning a war, no. He had come good 20-25 years earlier. He was given a refuge by the then king Udayandeva. This king came from Swat. Have you heard of the word Swat? A valley in northwest frontier province of Pakistan, 100 kilometers as the crow flies from Kashmir Valley, part of the Kashmir Janapada, as was then called from the state Mahabharata. Swat, incidentally, is the place where Panini was born. Panini, does the name ring a bell? The father of grammar, Ashtadhyayi, which today also perhaps is the most scientific work on linguistics. That's the land Swat. And who is it known for now? Mullah Radio, Fazlullah, Tehreek-e-Taliban, Pakistan. From that Swat came this noble renegade prince called Shah Mir, because he tried staging a coup there and he failed and he ran for his life, took refuge in this kingdom, and Udayande, could have been any Indian king, gave him refuge. Because he was from the nobility, the ruling family, he also gave him a place in his council of ministers, probably also gave him some land, some endowments. I can speculate, he must have felt that, you know, there is Islam that has reached Swat and they could well be hostile kings there, so it might help to keep someone from that region to know better on your side. By 1339, there were such circumstances that this king was deposed. With the consensus of the nobility, Shah Mir ascended the throne. And he ascended the throne with Raj Tilak and Mantruchar, with all Vedic, Shaiv, traditional ways of ascension. He came up. With him started the Shamsuddin dynasty that lasted 222 years and 25 kings. And once he was in, and he had someone called over, his spiritual master called Bulbul Shah, who insisted that there should be proselytization. Only then he can feel safe. He should consolidate his power by winning people over, by converting them to his faith. And when king starts professing a faith, it's very easy to win converts. They started winning converts, but it wasn't that easy either. For next 100 years, till 1450, Sanskrit remained the court language. Till 1450, successive generations of kings ascended the throne with Raj Tilak and Mantruchar, because it was necessary to keep the elite, the noble, the influential people of the society with you. In 1450, the one king who replaced Sanskrit eventually with Persian was the king called Zainul Abidin. We call him Badshah, the great king. We call him Badshah, the great king, because he was not as tyrant as his father. His father was called Sikandar Sultan, with a sobriquet, the Butshikan, the iconoclast. He earned his reputation demolishing temples and demolishing these statuettes in those temples. He is the one who unleashed an extremely barbaric, bloody conversion drive in Kashmir that drove Kashmiri Hindus out. That was the first exodus of Kashmiri Hindus. I don't know how many of you visited Kashmir or Anantnag or a place called Mutton, which was originally Martand, from where it has distorted into the name Mutton, M-A-T-T-A-N. It has one of the most magnificent ruins of the Sun Temple there. I don't know if you've seen a film called What was that film? The last song has this sun temple in... Heather. Yes. That temple is Marthand Sun Temple. India has four sun temples. One of them survives in Konark. The other three don't. They are in ruins. Another magnificent sun temple was in Multan, now in Pakistan. One is in Motera in Gujarat. And this one. Sikandar did not have gunpowder and he wanted to demolish it. It is a huge temple with massive stone boulders. Try as he may, he could not demolish it. So what did he do? He dug trenches around it, burnt acres of forest to the surrounding areas, piled up the wood there, burnt it, which burnt for months, some say 6 to 8 months. Still, those boulders cracked up but did not fall. And then he gave up. You have to just go there, look at it, shut your eyes and imagine the grandeur of what it must have been. It won't be difficult for you to realize. And that's what Kashmir has been through. This sun temple was built by Lalitaditya.